Over this past weekend, Tesla CEO Elon Musk sat down with CBS's 60 Minutes host Leslie Stahl to candidly discuss a whole range of things. And during the interview, Musk covered everything from his behavior this year, his Twitter activity, and that one time he ended up not inhaling but smoking pot live on the Joe Rogan show. And frankly, we could end up producing an entire week's worth of content from what Musk said in the interview. For example, he says he doesn't know how to smoke pot, something I'm sure many will believe based on seeing that episode, doesn't want to adhere to some CEO template and prefers to just be himself, views tweets as a way of expressing himself, says that Twitter is a war zone, and brings up the First Amendment in discussing what he says on said platform. When asked about his role at the company, Musk said he didn't want to go back to being chair of the company, stating he preferred no titles at all, and candidly stated that as majority shareholder, he can pretty much get everything done that he wants at Tesla using a shareholder vote. Oh, and he also made it very clear that while he respects the process of law, he has zero respect for the SEC. But perhaps the most interesting part of the whole interview, I've linked to it in the show notes so you can watch it for yourself, was the way in which Musk detailed Model 3 production line woes, the solution to it, and how he might consider buying GM's soon-to-be-shuttered factories. Admitting that Tesla was losing $50 to $100 million a week due to slower-than-planned Model 3 production, until, that is, Tesla made the massive temporary tent and a parking lot at Fremont for a third production line, Musk detailed how that third production line helped the company turn around. And even with lots of debt to pay off, mostly in the form of convertible senior notes, Musk confirmed that it was at least possible that Tesla would look into buying some of the General Motors factories whose closures were recently announced. But what does it mean? How would it work? And what would Tesla do with them? Let's get a little context by looking at the background. Last month, General Motors announced it would be closing five of its vehicle production facilities in the US and Canada as part of a $6 billion US cost-cutting plan. As part of this, it announced the end of production for next year for the Chevrolet Volt Range Extended Electric Vehicle, the Chevrolet Cruze, Chevrolet Impala, Cadillac XTS, and Buick LaCrosse, with the Cadillac CT6 due to end US sales next year. In total, 15% of GM's current North American workforce will also be laid off. It's all part of a plan to save money in order to help GM reposition itself for the future, plowing money into the development of autonomous and electric vehicles, and have plans to bring all new electric models to market in the next 5 years, while simultaneously ramping up production of the current Chevrolet Bolt EV. The announcement and the plan drew the ire of President Trump, whose government has since said in a retaliatory move, after Trump said he wanted to end any governmental assistance for General Motors, that it wants to end all electric vehicle and renewable energy tax credits. Musk, however, saw the news differently. Tesla's Fremont production facility, where Model S, Model X, and Model 3 are currently made, was formerly known as the NUMMI Manufacturing Facility. Run jointly by Toyota and General Motors, the plant was shuttered during the last recession, allowing Tesla the chance to not only purchase a ready-made facility and plant machinery at a massive discount, but also help revitalize the local economy, employing some of those formerly made redundant when NUMMI closed. These newly announced closures could help Tesla gain extra manufacturing space in the same vein, dramatically reducing costs for production expansion versus building new production facilities from scratch on a greenfield site. Musk's nodded responses to Stahl's questions over these factories certainly seem to suggest that, despite Tesla's already large financial commitments, extra production facilities could be possible. Moreover, Musk welcomed GM's push towards electric vehicles, reiterating that Tesla's existence was to accelerate the transition to zero-emission transportation and energy. Even if Tesla failed and became bankrupt, Musk noted, he'd still view it as a success if Tesla has spurred other companies to mass-produce electric cars and ditch petrol. Statements like this are rare in the automotive world, but it does show that Musk's goals are still more globally facing than perhaps personal. Musk's goals aside, however, does Tesla buying GM plants after they close make sense? Well, to be honest, I think it does. It's not clear if GM will even give Tesla the chance to buy these facilities, but assuming Tesla can secure funding and it doesn't spread itself too thin, bringing new production facilities online in the US could be a very good thing indeed for Tesla. First up, there's the whole proximity to Detroit. While Tesla is very much a West Coast company and has its roots firmly planted in Silicon Valley, establishing a production facility in Detroit or environs has its benefits. Not only are there plenty of trained factory workers, more post-GM layoffs, but there's a proximity to other mainstream tier one parts suppliers and associated industries that may make production easier and cheaper for Tesla. Second, there's the space. Tesla is operating pretty much at capacity now at Fremont, and while it's planning on opening a Chinese production facility soon, it's still going to need to increase Model 3 production in order to make that standard range Model 3 truly affordable while giving the company decent margins. Third, affordability. Living and working where the GM factories are closing, there are several different locations, is far, far cheaper than living and working in the San Francisco Bay Area. A reduced cost of living means workers getting paid the same as Fremont workers could certainly have a much better standard of living. Finally, there's all those extra planned models. Tesla's working on the Semi and hopes that to have that in production and on the road in just over a year's time. Then there's the Roadster with a similar timeline to production. And of course, there's the Model Y, a car which Tesla could certainly clean up the market with if it retails for a comparable price to the Model 3 as the X does to the S. More models means more space needed to produce them, and distributed production seems a smart way to go. Given Tesla is never afraid of spending money to make money, I honestly think it's incredibly likely we'll see at least one of these GM facilities trade hands with Tesla. After all, if GM wants to earn some extra money so it can make more electric cars, isn't trade with an electric car company the ultimate deal? Tesla helping accelerate the development of electric cars by buying factories from companies that can't afford them or don't need them anymore. That's it. Don't forget to give us your thumbs up or your thumbs down, leave a comment, and as always, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell below. Thanks to our Patreon supporters, without whom we'd never be able to produce all of these videos for you to all enjoy. Thanks to Karen Woods, Roger Smith, Julian Butler, Milam Curtin, and Alien Hulk, all of whom joined the ranks of Patreon patrons this month. You can join them for yourselves by going to patreon.com/transportevolved. Thanks for watching, and as always, keep evolving.